Hi, I'm Brian Cornes, Aerospace Market Director at MTS. AeroPro Software provides a tightly integrated control and data acquisition interface with unmatched control loop optimization tools to accelerate even the most complex high channel tests. MTS is constantly improving AeroPro with new features that make software easier to use, improve test article safety, provide new and better data visibility and integration, and improve test times that yield faster test results. In this ongoing series, we'll demonstrate some of these key AeroPro features. Today, we are joined by Bob Tieman, Senior System Integration Engineer. He's going to demonstrate a new AeroPro feature called Pinning Mode, which launched with version 7.4.0. Pinning Mode enables test engineers to easily and safely attach actuators to valuable test articles. Take it away, Bob.
Customers want a way to safely pin their actuators. They want a control typically to length or displacement, but limited on the amount of force that they apply when they're pinning their actuators. So AeroPro has added a pinning control mode, and which allows you to, with individual actuators, control in displacement control with a pinning input here, which is defined in inches, but you can limit on the force feedback that the load cell is seeing. In this case, I've set up upper and lower pinning limits at plus 3 and minus 3 inches, which is also shown here in this bar here, the light blue one. If I wanted to increase the pinning limit to, let's say, 3.5 inches, this value is increased right here, so it's a visual indicator to where once I exceed this upper or lower pinning limit and displacement, it's going to turn off hydraulics as a safety precaution. The far right bar here is your limiting input in force, and currently he's at plus 100 minus 100 pounds. Maybe if I wanted to increase that, I could go to 120 pounds tension, and now he should increase, yep. And then the middle blue bar here is showing the threshold settings, which are settings that indicate once I exceed this amount of force, I'm going to say stop moving in displacement because we're exceeding this threshold. We don't want to damage the test article. And the bandwidth indicates when to start kicking in from behind the scenes, switching from displacement control to force control, because we don't want to damage the test article. So this is when it starts mode switching to force control. If I want to start moving the actuator, I can adjust my pinning command here. I'm currently reading 2.23 inches in tension. If I wanted to move it out, I would put like minus 2 inches or minus 1 inch, and the actuator should move. So you can see he's going less positive, and you can see the bar changing here. So now he's gone to 1.23 inches. If I need to move a little more, I could go minus 1.5. Enter. Okay, there he goes. So now that if I have it where I want, I can pin the actuator up and then switch out of pinning control mode back into test execution control mode. Next, I'm going to demonstrate pinning mode on our bending beam and aero checkout with live hydraulics. I'm going to, the actuator is sitting in free space in displacement control. I'm going to push in force with my hand on the load cell, simulating the actuator hitting the test article. Initially, it'll move out of the way to stop applying too much force, and when I push enough and I exceed the limit, it's going to turn off hydraulics. Okay, now I'm going to simulate the actuator that I'm trying to pin as it impacts the test article. Currently, it's reading almost 0 pounds force. He's sitting in displacement control at 0.7 inches. Now I'm going to push on it to simulate compression. I'm at minus 16, minus 20 pounds. Once I get closer to minus 30, I'll be almost completely in force control. And at that point, it's going to move out of the way to protect the test article. You can see it's moving now. Now we're down to 1 inch retracted, 1.5 inches. Now, once where I remove that amount of compressive force, it's going to say, oh, I can go back to displacement control. It comes back out.
Thanks for watching. Please check out our other videos and MTS webpage for more information. If you are interested in leveraging these features, please reach out to your local rep about an AeroPro upgrade or training. MTS is committed to improving the AeroPro user experience and welcomes your feedback. Please contact us if you have ideas for new features. Thanks, and see you next time.